Chapter 26. Jason. Jason saw two options. Fight or talk. Usually, when faced with a creepy 20-foot-tall lady with jellyfish hair, he would have gone with fight. But since she'd call Percy brother, that made him hesitate. Percy, do you know this individual? Percy shook his head. Doesn't look like my mom, so I'm gonna guess we're related on the godly side. You a daughter of Poseidon, Miss... The pale lady raked her fingernails against the metal disc, making a screeching sound like a tortured whale. No one knows me, she sighed. Why would I assume my own brother would recognize me? I'm Kimopolia. Percy and Jason exchanged looks. So, Percy said, we're gonna call you Kim. And you'd be a, Nereid then? Minor goddess? Minor? By which, Jason said quickly, he means under the drinking age, because obviously you're so young and beautiful. Percy flashed him a look. Nice save. The goddess turned her full attention to Jason. She pointed her index finger and traced his outline in the water. Jason could feel his captured air spirit rippling around him, as if it were being tickled. Jason Grace, said the goddess. Son of Jupiter. Yeah, I'm a friend of Percy's. Kim's eyes narrowed. So it's true. These times make for strange friends and unexpected enemies. The Romans never worshipped me. To them, I was a nameless spear, a sign of Neptune's greatest wrath. They never worshipped Kimopolia, the goddess of violent sea storms. She spun her disc. Another beam of green light flashed upward, churning the water and making the ruins rumble. Yeah, Percy said. The Romans aren't big on navies. They had, like, one rowboat, which I sank. Speaking of violent storms, you're doing a first-rate job upstairs. Thank you, said Kim. Thing is, our ship is caught in it, and it's kind of being ripped apart. I'm sure you didn't mean to. Oh, yes, I did. You did? Percy grimaced. Well, that sucks. I don't suppose you'd cut it out then, if we asked nicely? No, the goddess agreed. Even now, the ship is close to sinking. I'm rather amazed it's held together this long. Excellent workmanship. Sparks flew from Piper's arms into the tornado. He thought about Piper and the rest of the crew frantically trying to keep the ship in one piece. By coming down here, he and Percy had left the others defenseless. They had to act soon. Besides, Jason's air was getting stale. He wasn't sure if it was possible to use a Baventus by inhaling it, but if he was going to have to fight, he'd better take on Kim before he ran out of oxygen. The thing was, fighting a goddess on her home court wouldn't be easy. Even if they managed to take her down, there was no guarantee the storm would stop. So, Kim, he said, what could we do to make you change your mind and let our ship go? Kim gave him that creepy alien smile. Son of Jupiter, do you know where you are? Jason was tempted to answer, underwater. You mean these ruins? An ancient palace? Indeed, Kim said. The original palace of my father, Poseidon. Percy snapped his fingers, which sounded like a muffled explosion. That's why I recognized it. Dad's new crib in the Atlantic is kind of like this. I wouldn't know, Kim said. I am never invited to see my parents. I can only wander the ruins of their old domains. They find my presence disruptive. She spun her wheel again. The entire back wall of the building collapsed, sending a cloud of silt and algae through the chamber. Fortunately, the Ventus acted like a fan, blowing the debris out of Jason's face. Disruptive? Jason said. You? My father does not welcome me in his court, Kim said. He restricts my powers. The storm above? I haven't had this much fun in ages, yet it is only a small taste of what I can do. A little goes a long way, Percy said. Anyway, to Jason's question about changing your mind. My father even married me off, Kim said, without my permission. He gave me away like a trophy to Briars, a hundred-handed one, as a reward for supporting the gods in the war with Kronos eons ago. Percy's face brightened. Hey, I know Briars. He's a friend of mine. I freed him from Alcatraz. Yes, I know. Kim's eyes glinted coldly. I hate my husband. I was not at all pleased to have him back. Oh, so is Briars around? Percy asked hopefully. Kim's laugh sounded like dolphin chatter. He's off at Mount Olympus in New York, shoring up the gods' defenses. Not that it will matter. My point, dear brother, is that Poseidon has never treated me fairly. I like to come here, to his old palace, because it pleases me to see his works in ruins. Someday soon his new palace will look like this one, and the seas will rage unchecked. Percy looked at Jason. This is the part where she tells us she's working for Gaia. Yeah, Jason said. And the Earth Mother promised her a better deal once the gods are destroyed. Blah, blah, blah. He turned to Kim. You understand that Gaia won't keep her promises, right? She's just using you. Just like she used the giants. I am touched by your concern, said the goddess. The Olympian gods, on the other hand, have never used me, eh? Percy spread his hands. At least the Olympians are trying. After the last Titan War, they started paying more attention to the other gods. A lot of them have cabins now at Camp Half-Blood. Hecate, Hades, Hebe, Hypnos, and probably some that don't begin with H2. We give them offerings at every meal, cool banners, special recognition in the end of summer program. And have I gotten such offerings? Kim asked. Well, no. We didn't know you existed, but then save your words, brother. Kim's jellyfish tentacle hair floated toward him, as if anxious to paralyze new prey. I've heard so much about the great Percy Jackson. The giants are quite obsessed with capturing you. I must say, I don't see what the fuss is about. Thanks, sis. But if you're going to try to kill me, I gotta warn you, it's been tried before. I've faced a lot of goddesses recently. Nike, Eclis, even Nyx herself. Compared to them, you're not scaring me. Also, you laugh like a dolphin. Kim's delicate nostrils flared. Jason got his sword ready. Oh, I won't kill you, Kim said. My part of the bargain was simply to get your attention. Someone else is here, though, who very much wants to kill you. Above them, at the edge of the broken roof, a dark shape appeared, a figure even taller than Chemopolia. The son of Neptune, boomed a deep voice. The giant floated down, clouds of dark viscous fluid, poison, perhaps, curled from his blue skin. His green breastplate was fashioned to resemble a cluster of open, hungry mouths. In his hands were the weapons of a Retarius, a trident and a weighted neck. Jason had never met this particular giant, but he'd heard stories. Polybdes, he said, the anti-Poseidon. The giant shook his dreadlocks. A dozen serpents swam free, each one lime green with a frilled crown around its head. Basilisks. Indeed, son of Rome, the giant said. But if you'll excuse me, my immediate business is with Perseus Jackson. I tracked him all the way across Tartarus. Now, here, in his father's ruins, I mean to crush him, once and for all.